Way back in 2013, the first lab-grown burger was unveiled to a skeptical and somewhat squeamish public. It was headline-grabbing stuff. I mean, who could resist a story about food critics tasting a burger made from cow cells grown in a test tube that cost thousands of dollars? And that didn't even include fries and a drink. Real meat without a real animal having to die for it? Well, that sounded like some cool futuristic thing that I couldn't wait to try myself. Well, 2013 was a long, long time ago in tech years. Are we really any closer to actually seeing this stuff on the menu? Or is cultured meat simply another flying cars techno fantasy? This is the Flexitarian Times. I'm Vince, and the short answer? Well, it looks like you'll be holding a lab-grown burger long before McDonald's has drive-through windows up in the air. Why do I think that, you might ask? Three reasons. The first reason, money. Before handing over millions of dollars to some wide-eyed entrepreneur who wants to change the world, venture capitalists tend to do a lot more due diligence and research than even some random YouTuber. If the risk-reward pencils out, they invest. Here's a chart of how much money has been raised each year by cultured meat companies since the early days of that pricey hamburger. As you can see, year after year growth has been steady and impressive. But here's what happened just last year, 2020, during a pandemic. Cultured meat companies led by Mosa Meats and Memphis Meat attracted over $360 million in new investment. That's more than six times the 2019 total. All of that due diligence must have uncovered some pretty encouraging stuff, don't you think? And that brings me to the second reason I think that cultured meat is getting ready for prime time: falling costs. A few weeks ago, the brilliant folks over at the nonprofit Good Food Institute released an in-depth report on the cultured meat industry. They did a top-down life cycle analysis of the economic viability and environmental impact of cultured meat. It's a very detailed report with lots of footnotes and references, but the bottom line is that there is a clear path to the commercial viability and ecological superiority of cultured meat. The GFI report finds that cultured meat will reach price parity or better versus some forms of animal meat by the end of this decade. In addition, assuming that the energy inputs come from renewables, cultured meat will have a significantly lower impact on the environment than the animal meat that it aims to replace. And of course, it'll also do away with concerns about things like mad cow disease, zoonotic diseases, antibiotics in the food supply, and last but certainly not least, animal suffering. Author and Uber investor Jim Mellon is a major force behind the clean food tech movement. He's one of those venture capitalists I mentioned who does a lot of due diligence. If you want to dig deeper into the future of protein yourself, I really recommend his new book, Moore's Law. I have a link to it in the comments. Anyway, according to Jim, there's a path to seeing the price of cultured meat drop, quote, significantly below the price of conventional foods in just 5 years. Okay, now put yourself in the shoes of a fast food CEO. If a burger or a chicken sandwich or burrito can be made using real meat that doesn't come from real animals, if it exceeds your company mandated carbon targets, you no longer have to worry about antibiotics and fecal contamination in your supply chain, and it can be had at a similar or better price, where do you think your fast food protein is going to be coming from? And finally, my third reason for believing that we'll soon be able to buy cultured meat is because, well, you are now able to buy cultured meat. Milestones are important, even if they're symbolic, and the company Just has just let us pass an important one. Meat made from the cultured cells of living animals has been approved for sale to the public for the first time in history by the government of Singapore. You can now book a table at the upscale restaurant 1880 and enjoy chef-prepared, very expensive chicken without harming any chickens. How cool is that? But it gets better. It was just announced that you can now have this cultured chicken delivered, a world first, put together by Eat Just, 1880, and global food delivery giant Foodpanda. Well, admittedly, that's a long ways away from snagging some cultured meat nuggets off the late night value menu, but anyone born in the last century who uses a smartphone can tell you how blindingly fast disruptions can occur once they really take hold. Whether it's plant-based, extracted from algae, pulled from thin air, or cultured from animal cells, or some combination of these, the way we get protein in our diets is in the midst of its biggest transformation in 10,000 years. And all the big action is taking place in this decade. Much of the incumbent food industry will fight it, but the economics of it will win in the end, just as they always have. Remember, sweeping change is kind of like a railroad crossing sign. It's good to be on the right side of it. Please consider taking a moment to hit that little like thingy if you found this video interesting, and subscribe to the channel to see more videos from the world of food tech. Until then, I'm Vince, and this is the Flexitarian Times. Thanks for watching.